How are you, everybody? Peter Pigskin Hebda along with Tim Smith, coach of Valley High School. And we are here for week 9 action in varsity high school football. Who's playing tonight? It's the Santa Ana Saints hosting the Jaguars, of course, out of Segerstrom here at the Santa Ana Bowl. And this one might be a bit of a knockdown, dragout game, coach. These are two schools that don't exactly, I think, like each other. And I hope I'm wrong, but we might see a few bodies carted off that field here tonight. Maybe.
Yes, this should be a very exciting football game, a lot of great hits, and it's all about city and the pride. And both teams are ranked number one, so it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm really looking forward to this football game.
Last year, Segerstrom won it. The year before, Santa Ana won it here. The year before, the Jaguars won it. It's been flip-flopped the last few seasons. Nice return there. Out of bounds he goes, and the Saints will have semi-decent field position. Semi-decent field position at around their own 30-yard line, and the winner of this game should come away a winner, or at least the league, share of the league championship, folks, in this league, in the Golden West League. So we got first and 10 for the Saints. Decent field position to start the game at their own 31-yard line. And the Saints wearing their dress reds, white helmets, and of course the Jaguars in their black pants, black helmets and the red trim, and a little bit of gold. So the Saints, and of course, Coach Smith. Tim Smith, of course, you are a proud Santa Ana Saint alum.
Yes, Sam, 1976, great class, and always, once the Saints, always the Saint.
And the older you get, the faster time goes by, right?
There's no doubt about that.
First and 10, the single back set, look out, breaks free in that wide, wide hole there in the middle. Blizzes his way down to near midfield, about the 45-yard line. Nice run, had a nice hole there, Coach. They got kind of neutralized in the middle of that defensive line.
Yes, sir, it was a great job up front, people blocking, making a great hole, first play of the game.
That was Alan Pacheco, running back, junior, 5'5", 140. Not a super amount of size on that Santa Ana side, but as far as the talent, kids touching the football, but they got some gutsy runners there. He gets the first down on first down, about a gain of 13 or 14. Not bad, first and 10 at their own 45. Brisanio takes it, off tackle to the left, and they get stuffed pretty quickly as the quarterback for Santa Ana is number 2. And on the stop for the Segerstrom Jaguars was number 44. He put the crunch on him, Christian Carmona, CC.
Yes, it's great to play up front. Like I said, it's going to be a battle of people up front. It's going to be one in the trenches.
I like the Saints linemen. They got not a lot of, well, probably the tallest guy on the Saints side there is big number 77. We'll get to the lineman here in just a moment. He's the left, right tack, pardon me. Screen here, long screen, it's caught. Nice dipsy-doodle running there. Gets about hard-earned 5 yards. Not bad. Yak, yak, yak. My favorite stat there for Pablo Aguirre. Yardage after catch. He did a good job of situating that football first and then taking off after.
Yes, Aguirre is a great ball player, too. He's very quick and he's elusive. And so you just got to be game tackle. You can't leave him one-on-one.
He's got that high step type of run, and he can be a little bit elusive. You got to watch out for him. Saints having a good year. Again, both these schools are coming in undefeated. Whoever wins here today is likely going to be the league champion. We got four receivers in, double split receivers. No tight ends are in. And this is Aguirre once again on the dash from the right to the left. Look out, he finds a slight, nice lane here. Dashes past everybody. We have a flag that's thrown. He's in the end zone. Wow, it's about a 50-yard scamper. Touchdown. But the flag was thrown at around the time that he was at about the 25-yard line. I'm not sure what happened. So I did not exactly see what happened. But, Coach, you're a coach. Maybe you had a better eye than I did.
No, I thought the only thing it could be is like holding when it's that type of play like that. It was a great ball. Great play, execution. We're bringing it back like it could be holding.
That's smart. So that was a beautiful play, too. He was practically untouched on that one. Wow. Santa Ana's number 17. Again, Pablo Aguirre. He is counted for a lot of variety of yards, both on the ground and through the air this season, and they like to use him on those short routes where he can find the lanes, and he did right there. They had some good blocking help downfield. Nice job, but it's all for naught. Now they're marching it upwards, strangely, and let's see here. Well, I guess it was a penalty at the site of the infraction or something, so they're giving him a first down. Strange to have a first down after a penalty. And it's first and 10, but that penalty nullifies, of course, the touchdown. So must have been a down-the-field penalty. Shotgun snap there, puts it up. And Aguirre comes back in to get it. Nice catch. He stays on his feet there, keeps his balance, but a couple guys put the crunch on him pretty quickly, about a 5 or 6 yard gain, and he did a good job of catching that ball in traffic.
Yes, he is. And like I said, that quarterback, Damian Messiah, he's one of the best players in Orange County that I've seen this year. He does everything, he's versatile. Running back, receiver, defensive back, punt the ball, and play wide receiver, and a great defensive back. So as he goes, the team goes.
One of the Briseños is out with injuries from camp earlier this season. Single back set, they come. Three receivers on the long side, the left side. It's second down and 4 yards to go. Keeps it on the ground, kind of loses his balance more than getting hit. And he's probably, Pacheco is just short of the first down, gets about a long two or a short three. He got blasted there by Seagram's number 84. 84 is Ulysses, the President Saucedo. Ulysses Grant Saucedo. Well, I'm not sure if that's his middle name, but that was one of the most corrupt administrations from what I understand in the history of our presidency. From what I know of my interest in my limited knowledge of history. Shotgun snap, they come on third and one, keeping on the shotgun. Quarterback takes off Macias. He bowls ahead for a couple. That's all he needed. He got it. First down, gutsy play. I like that. That no-fear type of quarterback, Coach, and he's not the biggest guy.
No, he's not the biggest, but he has a heart big as this mountain. But not only that, Santa has a great drive going from the first series, so hopefully he can keep going, or hopefully Sigurdsson can stop him.
Well, the Saints are looking sharp in this game. So far, so good. And they are efficient with this football. First and 10 at the 33, the plus 33. Again, out of shotgun. Macias, he sees a hole, he goes for it, and they catch him around the waist there. He had the right idea, but just couldn't elude the grasp of number 35 for Sigurdsson. Nice job by him. I don't have his name, unfortunately. Unless my eyes have seen me, unless it was 85. Emerson Aldana, who's a defensive end, I think. Yeah, it was probably him, Aldana. There is no 35 on the roster for the Jaguars. The just a picture postcard, perfect night for football. You can ask for it any better. It's high 70, mid 70s, and not much wind. It's beautiful out here, Coach.
Gorgeous, gorgeous. Great night for football.
Great night for football, and of course, in all the other parts of the country, it's cold. Over here, it's not. We're in Southern Cal. As a couple yards were gained there, and got a couple. Thanks. And it puts them out to about the 20, let's see here, the 28-yard line. So, yeah, they got to get to the 23. So this will be a money play here, folks, third and five. They got three receivers, to the long side, the left side of quarterback Macias. If you're a tight end on this Santa Ana squad, you're a lonely man. Low snap, he gets it off, thrown in, slant in, caught, wrestles for the extra yards. I think he's got a coach. He's going to be closer, going to be bringing out the sticks.
Yes, I think it's a little bit short, but that's my eyes. I can't tell. I'm getting a little older. It's hard to see.
He fell forward.
Yes, it looks like fourth and around one.
Those coaches like it when those guys fall forward. You can get kind of gain an extra yard in the process of falling down forward.
That's so true. Always leaning forward.
And every yard counts. They're fourth and less than 1 yard to go. They're in going forward formation. They're probably going to take their little sweet time to try and draw them off. A timeout is called by the Saints. I think they had some more time to go yet on the play clock. I they're probably going to run a play, because this is one of those areas of the field where maybe for a high school kicker at least, it maybe is a little too far to make a kick or too far for an attempt. And of course, you're way too close in for a punt. I'm not surprised they're in going for it formation. I wouldn't be surprised if they were going for it formation if it was like 4th-and-4, 4th-and-5, 4th-and-7.
Right.
But you see that a lot more commonly these days.
Yes, but right here is 4th-and-1. It's like if the game is all momentum, so Seagrass from the hole for a field goal, they're like Seagrass from the win, but it's Santa Ana want to go and keep the momentum going their way. So I believe Santa Ana's going to go for it.
I think you're right. Charlie Tavangort is in his third season as the head coach of the Saints. And he came over from Carson High School previous to here. And before that, he was at Compton High School. So he's been in some areas of LA County where he had some success. And they moved down here and opened up his program here in 2014. He replaced Carl Swanstrom, who still is, of course, teaching in the school district. I believe is an assistant somewhere. So they have an offset I formation here. They give it to the deep man. He breaks free. Look, he's got the first down and more. He's got past the 20. Still a thundering run. They try to get him by the shirt. He's still on his feet. And they don't even knock him to the ground. They just stop his motion and shove him out of bounds. But what a money run. How about that? By the Saints, number 5 there. And he made a great play of that one. And it was the better half of the Briseño brothers. Jorge Briseño on a dash all the way down to about the 5-yard line. Of course, I'd say the same thing if his brother made the play. But let's see here. Of course, the other Briseño is out with injury. And he has been hurt for the most part all season, unfortunately. I'll get into the details when we have a moment to spare. They come out of shotgun, first and goal at the 4. Look out. Out across they go. And it's a touchdown. That was Jorge Briseño. He had the last two plays of the drive. Comes up money, and the first drive comes up money. Touchdown with 6:56 here remaining in the first quarter, and that is good to see to establish a rhythm, a tempo, and a bit of a smash mouth way of doing it. I mean, I liked how they mixed the pass with the run because they didn't throw many deep passes. Their passing game is kind of an extension of, like, you could almost say like a West Coast type of offense a little bit.
Right. They study attack you with the dive plays, the pitch out, the swings to the wide receivers, and they're constantly putting pressure on you. That's what they do. They're one play away from breaking. Anytime they touch the ball, they got explosive ball players.
Yeah, they do. They have some exciting guys that can run and can move. Not only just the speed, but the combination of speed and the moves. The extra point is good, and it's 7-0 here. Coach, I don't know what happened to Valley last night. Of course, you guys played on Thursday night, the 27th. What was your end result with Anaheim?
Last night was a 49-10. It was a good game for us to come back and get that victory, because the week before, Catella took us to the woodshed. They put 70 on us. And we scored 40, but they put 70 on it. So the only way you can get back for that, we just wanted to get back to the football field the next day to get that bad taste out of our mouth.
That's all you can do. And, of course, you guys had your nephew was on the squad last year. He played in all the league games, and they won every game, I think, that he played. Maybe a tie game in there or something. But
yes.
And then at the last moment or right at the beginning of camp, I guess he transferred to North Orange County. Where did he go? Your kid, Sherman Thomas, man, that kid's one exciting player through the air and on the ground. I mean, for a replacement quarterback at the last moment, he's shining. You wouldn't think that he was a, quote, second string.
Yes, but I knew from his sophomore year, he got things that God given you can't coach.
He's exhausted himself. Right, so he's one elusive guy.
Yes, he is. Very talented. We're glad to have him with us.
And he throws a good pass on the run. That much I do know about him from seeing him a couple times this season. He's accurate on the run. I like that about him.
Yes, and he has this cool demeanor like Joe Montana. Nothing shakes him. So glad he's on our team. He's been probably the most valuable player on our football team so far this year.
So the bobbled return there, or the bobbled ball on the poor return, so it pushes Sigerson back to only about the 13-yard line. So relatively poor field position. And again, both squads coming in 8-0. Santa Ana did have a loss against Orange earlier in the season a couple weeks ago, 31-29, but they won that by forfeit because Orange used an ineligible player. About maybe 3 yards for the Jaguars or so. They push it out to about the 16-yard line, off tackle to the left side to the B gap, and they will be looking at second and let's see here. LA Market, yeah, that's about the 17, actually about a 4-yard gain, not bad. So Avalos, Marcos Avalos is a quarterback. I formation, or I should say one behind the quarterback and then one set to the right side, but they keep it down the middle here. A couple yards. Like Keyshawn Allen Keith Morales there. Keyshawn Allen.
Well, it was a great job by Seagrassen responding. Ball control, just coming back at you, full attack. So that's where we're at right now.
We'll get you the linemen here for the Jaguars. They're up to the first down. They got enough for the first down. They needed four. Well, they needed six. They got about six. Avalos gives it to the up man, the front man. Then he fakes the give to the deep man. Didn't fool too many, but they carve out a lot right there. About an 8-yard gain right down the middle, right between the guards. And right up the gut. Stop us if you can. Not bad. I think it was Vagulenti. It was 28 for Sigerson. 28 is, yes, Julian Vagulenti, fullback, senior, 5'10", 205 pounds. They're on the march. They're on the move. Out of their, they have a wing to the left side, but not, it's not double wing as they usually run. They run off tackle to the left this time, and then just kind of loses the balance, and it breaks down. But enough for the first down. They only needed about 1.5. They got about the 1.5, so they're running very efficiently and quickly, too. And I like the fact that these are old school schools that like to run a huddle. The huddle's not too far behind from the football. It's none of this, hurry-up stuff where there's no huddles. I like this style of football where it's run-centric, and you see old-fashioned huddles. I'm an old-school kind of a guy, Coach.
I'm the same way, too. That fact, I'm not in a hurry to do anything when the game of football, you know, so I'm all about that huddle also, too. So.
You ain't going nowhere. They got them on the wing from the right to, pardon me, yeah, from the left to the right there. Didn't fool anybody. They ran out of the double wing this time, which is what their usual formation is that they haven't run up till now, and they stuff them. Maybe half a yard was gained, and that was it. Good penetration by the defensive line for the Saints. It'll be second down and 10. Call it no gain. Your left to right lineman, Gabriel Moto, left tackle. He's a junior. All the rest of the guys are senior there. Seniors, pardon me, on the Seekersman side. Kevin Cabada, senior, left guard. The center, snapping the football. Andrew Magana, one of the captains of the team, I believe is a three-year starter. Paul Mora, senior, is a right guard. And the right tackle is Derek Liang. Here's the pitch. Ooh! Hit him hard, hit him low, wasn't about to let him go. What a nice penetration there. Wow. By Santa Ana's Jonathan Briceño. Briceño, cornerback. Nobody picked him up.
Yes, great piece of play for that Briceño brother. Like I said, they are football players. They will come up and hit you.
And he wrapped up really nicely, too. He wrapped up really well. And that's a sign of good coaching. And a kid who takes to it.
Yeah. Great play. So now it's third and round 12.
Pitches it, look out. If we have a flag thrown in the offensive backfield, they're probably going to bring this one back. He glitches his way all the way down to pass to the first down marker to about midfield, but they're going to bring this one back, I'm pretty sure. That was thrown well before he got past the line of scrimmage. They're bringing it back. So, yeah, the Briceño, there's not too many both-way players on the Santa Ana side. You only have two of them for Sigerson. Andy Magana, the lineman, plays line, you know, both lines, obviously, and Keyshawn Allen, running back and defensive back. Keyshawn is not one of the top gainers of yards on the ground, but he is usually in there. Not every play, but most plays on offense, most of the time. He's been a blocking back and a good one this season for a good portion of the year. And Santa Ana, they, other than Briceño kids, they only have two. Briceño was one other kid who plays both ways. So they got a lot of guys down there with energy because they're not. They don't have a high number of both-way players, Coach. That's good to see. They have some depth.
Yes, they do.
Both sides.
Yes, they do.
So the clock is being moved here. We're inside 4 minutes, 7-0 Santa Ana. Avalos, the lefty, cocks it back, puts it up. They're kind of low. Is it a low throw? It was. Did he get it? He got it. He caught it right around his, right below his waist, actually. It was a bit of a low throw, but he made a good effort to get it. Caught by Keith Morales, who's a wide receiver and a cornerback, junior, 5'9", 165 pounds. And that's not easy to keep possession of football when you're catching it below your waist. That could be risky.
Yes, it is. Yes. That's
where fumbles occur. But he did a good job of getting it secured. And then he got thumped. Fourth and 17. They needed a lot of yards to get for the first down. They had the right idea, but they got snuffed out early. They have to get to the 48-yard line for the first down. So, of course, they're punting it away. And it is punt right to the return man. He's got some room here on the left side looking for it. Look out. Can he turn the corner? No, he can't. He gets him around the shoulder and pulls him down. The return attempted there by Macias, the quarterback. You know, how often do you see a quarterback returning punts, Coach? That's a pretty. That might have been the first time I've ever seen that. I've watched football not as long as you have, but for a while.
It just shows what kind of athlete he is. That's true what you're saying, but there's nothing he can't do on a football play. Football field. He's been doing it since he was 8 years old. So
that's good to see.
Yes.
And he's one of the exceptions because he's played football as a youth, and a lot of the kids in the Santa Ana School District going to the public schools, and you know this, of course, you coach at Valley as an assistant. A lot of these guys are playing football for the first time when they reach high school. You know, the Latino kids a lot of times are playing baseball or soccer or other sports, and they're not used to football until they reach the high school level.
Yeah, and one of the reasons why, too, because of the weight limits. You know, these are some big kids, so they can't make weight for us. That's why we need to get youth programs, YMCA, the boys clubs, for these young guys during the summer have time to work on and train. So that's what we're lacking, I think, anyway, in Santa Ana.
Let's get you the lineman for the Santa Ana Saints, the Bruiser boys up front doing the grunt work, the busy work, the hard work. Left tackle is number 60. 60 is Enrique Duarte. He is a junior, 6'1", 330 pounds. I wonder what the food bills are in that family, Coach. I wouldn't want to have to pay for his eating. Not really.
Well, I'm glad I don't live with him.
Shotgun snap, of course. They are offset eye, and they come. Ooh, he got thumped there between two defenders. Did a good job of running in traffic there, and he got sandwiched, but took the hit, and he pops right back up. That was on the carry, Alan Pacheco. Number 77 is your left guard for the Saints in red. Mark Hernandez, offensive left 6'0", 285 pounds, pretty big kid. Number 67 is your center, snap of that football. Jesus Vieira with one R, 5'9", 255. We've got second down and 5 yards to go from their own 29. Macias wants to put it up, puts it deep. Look out, there's a little bit of contact, and there is no flag thrown. It was, I guess you could argue, it was incidental. They were both kind of going for the ball. I didn't see anything really flagrant there, Coach. It's right in front of us. I thought that was a good non-call.
Yes, that was a great defensive play by the defensive back. It's like the ball, when it goes up there, it's for the receiver or the defensive back. So that was a great non-call on that one.
Yeah, he made the referee did the right thing by keeping the flag in his pocket. There was some contact, but again, it was because they were both going for the ball. They were both going for the ball. Nothing flagrant there. And of course, the rule is the defender, at least in the official's eyes, has as much right to the football as the pass catcher would. Correct. Jesus Vieira, center, snapping the football. Right guard is number big number 65, Jose Zaragoza. And the right tackle on the far right side, big number 70, Francisco Franco, 6'2", 320. Look out, he bursts free right down the field, right down the middle. Still going, he turns, he makes a little bit of an angle shift there to get away because he was aware of the players behind him. But what a blistering run. How about that? Number 5, Jorge Briseño. He shows why he's one of the most exciting guys when he touches that football. When he's out in the open field, he's got that high kick style of running, and he's also a pretty strong kid for his size. Briseño is fast for his size, too. He's 5'8", 155. It looks bigger than that to me, but that's a strong 155-yard kid, and he's got good speed and good moves. He's versatile. I like
yes,
this.
Yes, he's very built, compact, and
like I said, look out. Hang on the ball. They bobble the football. I think the Saints have got it back. And, of course, folks, don't forget rule number one of the game of football. Maintain possession of the football.
Always. You always got to secure the ball.
And don't forget, folks, possession, as far as I can remember, it's still, Coach, 9/10 of the law.
Yes, that's true.
Second and 14. They lose 4 on that botched play, so they'll be looking at snapping it from the plus 35-yard line. Still very good field position, but they want to do something with it. Less than 2 minutes to go in the first half. Shotgun snap to Macias. Look out. He's looking. Everyone's covered. That's why he doesn't want to throw it. Puts it up underneath. It's caught. It's caught, and he had a guy on him, too, but the defender was right behind him, and he was right on him like a cheap suit, but he still made the grab, and he threaded the needle on that one, too. That was a nice catch there. Wow, by number 13, Chris Nava. Nava, wide receiver, senior, 5'9", 185 pounds. Give Macias, the quarterback, some credit. He did a good job of threading the needle on that one.
Yes, he has. Like I said, he's one of the most viable players on all of Orange County high school football to me. I've been keeping up with this kid. He's just a great athlete, smart, and very intelligent.
Yeah, he is, and he's just one exciting player. I like seeing him play. Shotgun snap. Here they go. Deep man takes it. Look out. Just kind of blasts bodies and clunks bodies with the would-be defender. Down he goes, maybe a couple yards. A couple guys involved in the crunch there. Main guy to lay the lumber there for Seegerson. Number 2, Keith Morales, cornerback. Saints get it up to the 16-yard line or so. Yeah, 16-yard line, plus 16. Taking a little sweet time out of the huddle. We've seen a clean game here. We've only seen about 2 penalties so far in the first quarter here. Now, I'm an omen. Watch all the penalties flags start flowing now that I mentioned it.
No.
I hope not.
No, me too.
I like seeing clean football. I know you do too, Coach. All right, here. Look out. Plenty of room on that right side. Look out. Lofts it too far into the corner of the end zone. Intended guy there for Santa Ana was 17, Pablo Aguirre. And I get a sense there was some kind of miscommunication on that play maybe.
Yes, I did. I thought the receiver cut up short. He didn't come out full speed, so maybe he didn't think the ball was coming to him. That's what I could figure.
Yeah, that was kind of a strange incompletion. I haven't seen one like that in a while. So 45 seconds, 3rd and 6 it'll be from the plus 11. So they're in field goal range, but these guys are hungry. They want pay dirt. They want to visit the end zone here once more at the old but very nice and quaint Santa Ana Bowl here, Santa Ana Municipal Field. Eddie Westfield puts it low snap. Ooh, it's batted away. Hands go up, but the ball goes down. That could have been a lot worse there. Oof. He was just down at the right angle maybe to get under it and intercept it, but nice bat away there by, I think, number 5 there. by Sigerson number five, Angel Lopez. Or I'm probably number eight, Correa, yeah. Offensive outside linebacker. Bats it down, yeah, number eight. Your eyes are better than I am. Mine, you got glasses, I don't. Yeah.
That was a great play.
You did a good job.
Yes, he did. Got back in the zone, curled a flat, and he was there. Did exactly what a strong safety post to do. Stay in the zone, knock the ball down, or pick it off.
So they're in field goal formation, pardon me. Santa Ana's number 19, and there for the booting duties, Ishmael Mojica, M-O-J-I-C-A, pardon me, junior, 5'7", 165. We had a whistle, but I don't think anybody called timeout. No, they're just kind of resetting. I guess they didn't have the ball placed where it should have been. This will be a 23, 24, about a 34-yarder. Probably in the range of a high school kicker. Bad snap. Look out. They're going to run out of play out of desperation. This is not a planned play. It was a bad snap. Aguirre looking for some room there, and he's got the first down, I think.
I think he came short. My eyes, my opinion, he was short.
I'm gonna argue with you on that. I'm going to say he got it. We're going to see where the spot's going to be, but yeah, it is. You're right. They're not even measuring. How about that? He's about half a yard short. He made a valiant effort. I thought he had it. He was just a little short and got chased out of bounds at an angle. And again, that was not a planned play, folks. It was just a bad snap. I think they had every intention of kicking it because I could see how it was snapped. It was short. It was on the ground. It was flat. So the Sigerson Jaguars dodge a bullet. They are still trailing, but only by seven. Here with 32 seconds to go in the first quarter. They haven't shown much offensive prowess in this game. Well, they have shown some on their only drive. This will be the only second time touching the football. We have a timeout taken. Looks like Sigerson is calling timeout. While you have a chance, let's get you the coaching staff for the Santa Ana Saints. Charlie Tavancourt, he's the head coach and offensive coordinator. He's his own OC. He's an on-campus man. I believe he teaches special education classes. David Gutierrez is the defensive coordinator. John Tukia is the offensive lines coach, the quarterbacks coach. He's been a coach for a long time. Bill Lux. And running backs and defensive backs helping out with them is Dakota Lambert. The other defensive backs coach is Chris Brown. Chris also coaches the special teams here for Santa Ana. He gets some help from some of the other coaches, but it's mainly him. Linebackers coach, Hector Uresti. He's the linebackers coach, and he's also an alum from Santa Ana High School. Do you know Hector, coach?
Yes, I do. My coach, as a matter of fact. Great football player, great person.
And defensive lines coach is Thomas Salue, S-A-L-U-E. And that rounds out your staff for the Saints. And the Saints High School, Santa Ana Saints, is a little over 3,000 kids. They got 55 players on the roster, and the JV is seven wins and one loss. So they look for good future players to come up from that program, starting probably next season. Down the middle they go. I think it was Vaglianti on the probably about 4 or 5 down the middle. Yeah, that was Vaglianti, and he pushes forward. Had a little bit of blocking help down the middle there. That's the one thing I like about the Jaguars. They're not afraid to run it right up the gut, and if that's working, they're going to continue with it. You know, stop us if you can. No surprises, you know. Are you strong enough to stop us right down the middle?
Yeah, they're a very physical football team.
They are.
You know, they don't back down. They come right at you also.
And while they're not a throw-heavy team, although you'll see them go for it every now and then on first down, and Avalos, he's the quarterback. He's the lefty. He's been there. This is his third season as a starter. You know, I've seen games covering Sigerson down through the seasons, coach. We've, basically shot games since the 09 season, so I've been down here for a while. They have seemed, you know, under Mike Masarenka and, of course, now Joe Tagaloa, the head coach, their offensive lines year in, year out always seem to me to be very, very well coached. As you know, as a coach, it's not all about size and strength, of course. That's a good part of it. That's a big part of it, sure. But just their footwork and their balance has been excellent, because I've seen them control schools that have got bigger linemen than they do, or heavier or stronger linemen, at least as far as weights and sometimes heights go. And I've seen them control the defensive lines like that. Their coaching is excellent, and has been excellent down through the season, especially on the offensive line, without question.
Yes, I totally agree. They really sound fundamentally sound. They're smart kids, and they work as a unit, you know, as a unit. And I just give credit to the coaches, you know. I'm getting them there, the technique, and they work, like I said, again, as a unit. And once you work as a unit, that's hard to beat.
Rustamin is the offensive lines coach for the Jaguars. Of course, Tagaloa is just like Devant, he is head coach and offensive coordinator. Most head coaches are usually one or the other, the DC or the OC. And it's rare that they're not. So we've got a second down and 3 yards to go for the Jaguars. Avalos is up to the line. We have three out of the backfield, one behind, and the two wings are there. And they kind of do a little bit of a curly misdirection run there, and doesn't really fool too many, as I think it was number 33 on the carry there. got flattened by the middle of the defensive line there for the Saints there. Number 33 is Dennelson Santamaria. Love saying that last name. Santamaria gets maybe one or two. And probably not a huge offensive defensive line for the Saints. Probably the biggest guy there. They haven't got a huge size there, really. It's 90, Pablo Arredondo. Arredondo is 5'10", 240. Looks a little bit lighter than that to me, but, of course, I'm up here about a good 120, 150 feet away.
Right.
But, yeah, he looks about 240. Maybe he looks maybe 20 pounds lighter than that, but he's a good inside lineman. Okay, third and one, money play here. We have whistles and flags, We got a dead ball foul. They're going to mark it out. Yeah, they're guilty of the offside, so the Saints kind of sort of line up in the neutral zone. I didn't see anybody kind of jump the line there, but can't do that, of course. Offsides, encroachment, whatever you want to call it. They'll move the sticks here, and that's a big shot in the arm for the Jaguars. Of course, it gets in the first down by way of the penalty. And hey, first down by way of the penalty is a first down no matter which way you cut it.
Yes, no doubt about it.
So the Jaguars looking for more here. Again, they're down 7-0 in a tightly fought game here. They're taking some time here out of the huddle. Be wary of the play clock here. They come with one receiver deep to the right side. Wing back to the right. Single back set. Ooh, hit him hard right around the middle there. Wow. Nobody picked him up. Number 45, that squat build. Santa Ana's number 45. Let's see here. That is Kevin Kia. C-E-A. Never seen a last name like that. Senior, 5'7". How many guys are built 5'7 and 245? Just linebackers and fullbacks. That's it. You ain't going to see anybody else on the roster with that build and that height. No. Nowhere.
That's like a little pinball machine. You know, that's a little.
Yeah, low center of gravity. That's definitely somebody you do not want to get hit by.
No, not at all.
I wouldn't. I know that. I only weigh 162 pounds. I'm in shape, but I ain't big. All right, second and 14. Avalos, look out. He's got a guy coming from the blind side. He's hit. The ball is bobbled. The pass goes forward, but the throwing motion, that'll be an incomplete pass. That's the right call there. That's the right thing. And so he threw it. Third and 14 from their own 22. So they have an extra, I think, on the tight end and a wing back to that right side. They run to that strong side, the right side, but it doesn't do much good. The blocking help should have been there, and it wasn't. It broke down maybe a yard if that, and a couple guys involved in the stop for the Saints there. Or was that number 8? Let me see, maybe number 6 or number 8 there. Punting tonight is Marcos Avalos, the quarterback. Puts his foot into it, heavy rush, a poor punt or kind of a low punt. Not much distance to it, and it takes about a neutral bounce, and of course no Saint will return it, but still excellent field position for the Saints. Down the middle like a knife through soft butter, look out, nice move to keep himself on the field, and he finally gets cracked from behind, but not before the damage is done is Briseño with the tilde over the end, gets about 15 yards on that one from the 50 to the 35. Nice job by him. This Briseño kid, man, he was an exciting, poised player as a sophomore. I remember seeing him play a couple times with you on games we did.
Yes.
And both these Briseño kids, talented. I'm sure they had to play youth football. Didn't come in not playing football when they were before high school years. No way.
No, they're legendary. They're known throughout Santa Ana how good they were going to be whatever high school had them was going to be. Blessed to have either one, but have both on the same team. That's a blessing.
Exciting players. They're twins, of course. Pitch there to Briseño from the quarterback, Macias. Legs go flying at the end. Down he goes. Kind of lost the football at the end, but he was already down. But he's fine, and he gets inside the 32, about the 27-yard line. Not bad. He got about an 8-yard gain. Not bad. Clock is ticking here. Again, the Saints are up 7-0. And, I would say, the Saints' biggest kid on that offensive line has got to be, number 77. Height and weight both. Mark Hernandez, it's not. Mark Hernandez is the second biggest. He's 6'0", 285. And they got one guy down there that's 320. Briseño, not much there. Got flattened early by big number 70, Francisco Franco. And Francisco Franco, number 70, is the biggest guy. 6'2", he's a junior yet still. 6'2", 220. That's the frightening thing about Francisco Franco, coach. He's 6'2", 320. He's got another year to play, another year to grow. And again, a family to feed him still. That's a lot.
Yes. That's college, NFL type size.
Yes, it is. Keep your grades up, folks. You're going to be able to move on to the next level. That's the first thing they look at. Flag is shown as a play ends, and down goes the ball carrier. You scampered forward. Not bad. Good effort there. Got crunched there around the midsection and the rear end. Alan Pacheco. Pacheco, is he high steps it down about the 18-yard line, but again, we have yellow laundry on the field, and the Saints are kind of marching back. I think it's against them. As oh, man. It is holding indeed, so that kind of stinks. So they had a bit of a nullification and an efficient drive here. That can really take the wind out of your sails. That can be a mood killer, but they're moving it nicely, though. Bumping the road probably for them. They'll be looking at first and 15, still excellent field position from the positive 30-yard line, the plus 30. Macias out of shotgun. A little bit of motion there. And it's given to Paolo Geary. Geary looking for some room on the outside lane. Can he find it? He turns a corner, puts a stiff arm, and he just gets dashed out of bounds. He dashes his way out of bounds. Not bad. He got about a good 10-yard, about a good 9 yards on that one. As they were, again, 5 yards behind the down markers, you can see it. That was a first and 15 play, right? First and 15. So he gets them out to about the 20, or where are they going to mark this football? The 22, about 8 yards. I overestimated it. About 7 or 8 yards. Not bad. Second and about 7 or 8. We'll call it a long 7, a short 8. Three receivers in the long side, the right side of the quarterback of Geary, or the quarterback Macias, pardon me. Puts it up in a slot man. Little too high. He wants that one back like a big dog. Incomplete. Was intended for Nava. Chris Nava, wide receiver, senior, 5'9", also plays a little bit of free safety. And good thing there was nobody around him, because when you stretch your guys out like that, coach, that's how guys can get height.
Yes. No doubt, brother. You got to get the ball down the lower. Like, yeah. I said, I believe the ball just got out of his hands. A good call by the offensive coordinator. Secretary's lucked out.
That's how you can get an occasional broken rib or the wind knocked out of you when you're a receiver. You don't like to make stretching grabs like that. Incomplete. Too high. Third down and 8. Same formation they come. He goes to his single receiver on that short side, the left side, fighting for yards. Didn't get it. Got him. Made him really lose his balance more than anything else. And that was Briseño on the catch. He didn't have much to go with. Down he goes.
Hurt his leg again. I mean.
Yeah, he's favoring a leg. You're right. Yeah, I think you're right. So, again, he's had injury problems all season long. Jonathan Briseño. And makes the catch, but not much there. George Briseño had the ACL, and Jonathan Briseño had the shoulder problems all season long. He was the MVP player out of this league, the Golden West League, in the 15 season, 2015, and for good reason. Fourth and 11, they're in going for it formation. Not surprised. Look out. They send four receivers out, three on the right side. They go down, go into the corner of the end zone. Oh, it's incomplete. Oh, man. Didn't quite have his body behind it at the right angle. The throw was there, but it was just a little bit off. Incomplete. Coach, you look at that. What do you see?
That was a great call. Like I said, just a timing route. That was a good call by the offensive coordinator. Just like they just couldn't connect.
Yeah, Nava was out there. The defender was nearby him. He had a chance at it just for a split second, but between the height of the ball, it took a little time to come down, and his angle and his body wasn't fully behind it. All the factors weren't there in his favor. Incomplete. And the Saints, again, they're moving the football, but the last two drives, they've come up empty. Look out. First and 10 for the 26. A couple yards gain maybe for the Jaguars. Again, they like that inside stuff. When it doesn't work, they'll change things up, but they mainly keep it on the ground. Avalos has had an efficient year. He's only averaging about 100 yards, 120 yards a game throwing the football. They don't ask him to do that much, but they'll throw it at times where you think they're certainly going to run it. Every now and then they'll surprise you with a first down throw. That's not uncommon with the Jaguars. Second and 6. Out of the wing they come, and double wing they come, and the player kind of gets crunched there early down at around the 35-yard line, lost his balance, combination of getting hit and losing his balance both. Main perpetrator on the play is the all-everything kid, Damian Macias, who plays quarterback, and, of course, return man, wide receiver. He's got a wide resume, let's just say, Coach.
Yes, he's a great year. Like I said, I've been following the Saints, and every time you look up, he's done something amazing. So having a great year.
Strong side to left side this time for the big time. They got two guys on that right side, the left side of the center, only two on the right, four on the left, and they go to that strong side, but not much there. Good penetration by the Saints there. They're doing a good job of that tonight. They've had a few plays on them for some long runs, but they've had some stops early too. 7 and 8 converge. 7 is Santa Ana's Joshua Brito, B-R-I-T-O. 5'7", 155. And Steven Cruz has had a really good season from this year. He's having a bang-up year for him, literally and figuratively. 6'3", 285, defensive end. That's one guy you don't want to have tackle you. He's a tough player. And he was an all-league player from last year as well. Steven Cruz, fourth and one. They're in going forward formation, less than one. Look out, they're going to take some time on this snap here. They're probably going to try to draw him off. They do blow the whistle. So they call a timeout before the penalty can be thrown. So they tried to draw him off. It didn't work. The Saints stay disciplined. That's good football. I like seeing that.
Yes, it is. Heads up, because like I said, the offense tries to draw you off. The kids, I mean, defense line, they're just ready to attack, you know, looking for the anticipation. So just it'll make you jump off sides. So that's what they're hoping for. But they were just disciplined.
Didn't work. I was not expecting him to really run a play. That was the whole strategy, because again, it's fourth and one, or less than one, 4:17 to go, plenty of time for a score for anybody getting touching that football. And of course, you're doing it from relatively deep in your own territory. You're on about the 30-yard line. You don't want to turn it over that deep. So they'll be coming out, I'm sure, to punt here. The Santa Ana Saints coming in this game again, 8-0, 3-0 in the league. Last year won a hard-fought game against Ocean View. Tavant Gort said in the Orange County Register it wasn't pretty, but we won. He says we had a smash-mouth game that we took control of. The Saints beat Godinez to start the year, 36-12. We taped that game here at home. Really dominated them in that game. Beat Anaheim 36-0 here as well. Then went on the road three times in a row at Marina High School out of Huntington Beach, 33-21. Actually, they are going forward on fourth and one. They stay in going forward formation. I think the Saints stopped them. Not much there. The left side of the defensive line makes a stop. I think they're going to mark it short. The offense is coming out, and you're right. And it didn't fool anybody. As it was, I think, number 23 there for Segerstrom had it. Or 33, pardon me. I think that was Denelson Santa Maria. Didn't fool them. First and 10 for the Saints. Plenty of room, plenty of time to work with. They've at least, they got two timeouts, so they're sitting pretty, Coach. Can't ask for better than starting a drive at the positive 34-yard line, and you got two timeouts. That's money.
Yes, that was a gutsy call by the offensive coordinator for Segerstrom. So
it didn't work. So Briseño goes on a long angled run there, just kind of dashes his way out of bounds, avoids a hit. That's just smart football, as he realized he wasn't going to make any more yards if he put his body into it. I like seeing that because, you know, a lot of people, he runs out of bounds. Well, you know what? Sometimes as a football player, you know you got no chance or very little chance of making extra yards. Why take the hit? Play it safe. You know, preserve your body as much as you can. Run out of bounds. I don't blame him.
That's right. Get what you can and get out, because now it's all about momentum and the time. The clock's at your hands.
You got 8 yards on that. I thought it was less. That's a nice did a lot of running for those 8 yards. Ooh, a high snap. Look out. But he gets a lucky bounce. Macias throwing it on the run there. He tosses it. Was it intercepted? It hit a Jaguars player, but did he intercept it? No, they say it's incomplete. The Jaguars player was literally on his knee or on his rear end on the field. His arms were near it. The throw was just, he was throwing it just to avoid the sack for the most part. There was a player nearby. It wasn't going to be grounding or anything like that, but that could have been worse as it hit the player near the leg and not the upper body. If it was a little bit different, it could have been an interception with him literally on the ground. And what a weird play. So, again, keep control of that football, folks. Again, those long snappers, you got to be careful. That's a learned art. Third and two. Again, because they just bring it back to the original line of scrimmage. Down he goes. A dive right in the middle of the field there. Nice job there by Santa Ana's number 20. 20 is, let's see here, Alan Pacheco, the running back. And he gets his guys up to... first down, yep, they needed two. They got about three or four. It's going to be marked at the 21-yard line. Had some decent blocking help. Got enough. And, again, the Saints are taking their time here, letting the clock tick, coming out of the huddle. Two out of the backfield, they remain. A little bit of motion there, a little change of positions by the up man, but Briseño takes the carry here, and he is in the end zone, folks, nearly untouched. What great blocking help down the middle. In he goes at the touchdown, a 21-yard scamper. And I'm sure that Briseño himself will say that he can attribute that to the good carving out of his inside of his offensive line. Great job.
Yes, great execution by the offensive lineman. So, like I said, this football game is pretty heads up. I mean, a gutsy car by the coordinator for Segerstrom to make that call, because now it comes back and bites him. So,
we see an interesting variety of play calling here tonight. The inside of the line includes numbers, the guards in the center. The center is Jesus. Jesus Vieira, and you got your inside guards there. Your inside guy is 77. On the left side is Mark Hernandez. There's the kick. Looks good to me on the south end of the field. Looks good to the officials, and looks good on the scoreboard. 14-0, a touchdown in each in both quarters here so far for the Saints tonight. And they have played, for the most part, Coach, some shutdown football. They've had a few penalties, a few adventures with the football there, like we saw with the high snap. But for the most part, they're playing some hard-nosed, disciplined football offensively and defensively. I'm liking what I'm seeing so far.
Yes, it is. You can contribute to the coaching staff from Center High School, like I said, and both teams. Very heads up, very smart football plays. The score is only 14-0. Like, it's still early. Like I said, both teams undefeated and dangerous. So we got a long way to go in this football game. So
the Saints got to feel good about what they got. We keep it going on a beautiful night for football here. The last Friday in October, October the 28th, from, of course, Santa Ana Bowl. They replaced this field, the natural field, a number of years ago to the light plastic grass with that rubber pellet base, which is made from shredded tires about 10 years ago. And, of course, it's low maintenance. Bouncing kick here. Look out. He touches it. Doesn't have to be touched by anybody. Just anybody's football once it travels 10 yards. And, again, they've had troubles on the return here tonight. Down goes the would-be return man. He doesn't get much yardage there. A swarm of Saints in there. Main guy to lay the lumber for the Saints in red. Number four, Gonzalo Cherez. Chair like sitting in a chair. Easy at the end. Down goes the ball here. So, again, field position has been a bit of a factor here. More than a bit of a factor for the Jaguars. They've had poor field position for the most part all night long. So they'll be looking at first and 10 from their own 13-yard line. Second time they're starting a drive from their 13. And they're taking their time out of the huddle here. And then we'll get to the coaching staff for the Jaguars as well. One kid that's not starting tonight is a regular middle linebacker Jaguars, David Sevilla. He is out because his mom passed away in her sleep. She died a couple days ago, which is hard for anybody. I mean, I'm not looking for that day when that happens. And, of course, I'm older. My parents are still around. I'm lucky.
Amen. Amen. Praise God.
Indeed. And they're healthy. I can't complain. They should be around for a while, barring any accidents. That was number 30 on the scamper there for Segerstam. And Joel Sepulveda, just like the boulevard in L.A. County. That's the longest road in L.A. County, in L.A. City. Sepulveda Boulevard. Second and 5. He got 5 yards on that. I thought it was less. Nice job by him. Look out. Nice little hole there on that B gap. Not bad. And that was Segerstam's Lopez. Number three, Keyshawn Allen on the dash. Not bad. Got clobbered there by a couple of guys, including one of the linebackers there. Looked like number 31 was wreaking havoc on that play. Roger Leone, outside linebacker, 6'5", 158 or 160 or so. Nice stop. Segerstam, pardon me, they've got one timeout remaining. They're letting the clock tick here. They're looking at third down and 3 yards to go. This is going to be a major money play for them here. From the Saints, I'm going to try to stop them up and get that ball back. Why not? Your offense is clicking. They come from their double.
Delay a game.
Yeah, they're getting flagged. There you go. You saw it coming, Coach. You got a better eye and a better ear for knowing the play clock than I do, and they throw the flag, so it changes it entirely from third and three to third and eight. And when you get a situation like that, third and three from third and eight, that calls for different types of plays to be called, as you know.
Yes, it does. Yes, it does.
Your things to choose from are not as wide and available as they are, you know, third and eight versus third and three, as you know.
Right. And not only that, the clock is not—it's not in their favor right now. We got a minute and a half left, and third and long, so Santa Ana might call a timeout after this. And like I said, if they pass the ball incomplete, it'll stop the clock. They catch the ball, and it'll make it first down, and it'll stop the ball. So it's a very crucial play right here.
Yeah, they keep him in bounds. They might call a timeout to get the ball back. I wouldn't be surprised if they did that, if the Saints did that. They go down the middle. Oh, hit him in the hands. He didn't have his body behind it quite, though. Oh, man, he wants that one back like a big dog. Angel Lopez, who's had a good season for him this year, 5'8", 180. Incomplete. That, of course, stops the clock because an incomplete pass always stops the clock. And, man. So, again, that was, you could argue he should have had it, but he didn't quite have his body behind it to get the juxtaposition to be able to secure it. That is so important, yeah, to secure it with your, not just your hands, but your chest, as you know. So they're punting once again. Avalos, the quarterback, stands back to boot it away. He's got a lot of pressure, and he's been under a lot of pressure tonight with these punts. And he lets out a very poor punt. It only gets out to the 25-yard line. So he's had his troubles here tonight. The Jaguars are fortunate to be down, in my opinion, by 14 points, Coach.
Yes, they're lucky to be down by 14 points. But like I said, we got a minute 29 left. The ball's on the 25-yard or the 20-yard line or so. They got to definitely hold them at least three, if none at all.
Yeah, the Saints, my gosh, I mean, they've been starting their drives. I think they've had one. I don't think they have any drives, maybe one, inside the that has not been inside the 50. So putting a lot of you're taxing your defense heavily if you're the Jaguars here. Persenio really puts his he squares his shoulders and really puts the hit onto the defender, and then the other way around. Down he goes. Gutsy run. Gets about 3 yards or so, maybe. One of the backfield kids, or one of the looks like one of the linebackers actually came up to make the stop. I think it was 25. Medrano, outside linebacker, senior, made the stop. Briseño with a nice hole there. Didn't last long, but he didn't need it for too long as he glides his way down inside the 10. He finally, his body goes down around maybe the 7 or 8 yard line. And as that's the one thing I like about this kid, Briseño. He's speedy, he's strong, and he's he can take a hit. He goes down forwards for the most part when he falls down. And he didn't have much of a lane there, but you know what? He doesn't need much of a lane. It closed around behind him, but bam, he's through right quick. I mean, he's maybe not the speediest guy, but he's got good quickness. He gets up to top speed very quickly. That's what quickness is.
Yes, and on top of that, he has a lot of heart. Like I said, he's like one of those bull riders. He's constantly go yeah. on nothing but force and penetration. You know, he attacks you. He don't let you attack him. He attacks you, and that's a smart play of a football player and a running back.
Well, I remember that early season game we did back in 14, two seasons ago, Coach. It was at the Segerson High School with Santa Ana. It was our home opener against Century. And, I mean, the Briseños were both sophomores. They were both starters back then. There was Charlie Tavankowitz, I think, first or second. I think it was the first game, but it was a Saturday afternoon, really warm, really hot, real sunny. And I know they had something. I knew they had something special in those guys from that game on. And it was really something. That these, and they seemed so poised even as sophomores. I was really shocked.
Yes, you have a great memory. I do remember that afternoon game also. And I knew from that day on, that first time I ever seen them, they were going to be something special.
Yeah, they are. They're fun to watch, man. They're something else. All right, first and goal from the 8. Plenty of chances to do something with it. 54 seconds remains. This is Briseño. We're looking for some room as he drags guys with him. Like a valiant warrior pulling that ball forward, trying to get as maximum yardage as he can. He goes down. His knee was down around the 3. The ball is laid down around maybe the 1.5. Where are they going to mark this one? It'll be second down. The clock continues to tick. The Saints do have one timeout remaining, so they'll probably maybe run a pass play here, and they can still run a running play. Because, of course, if you get stopped in the middle of the field, the clock does not stop if you run the ball. This is Macias. As he gets across the end zone at an angle, and he goes. Touchdown with 27 seconds remaining. Just domination here in the first half by the Saints. How about that? It is 20-0 as the Saints. And, again, they've been working with a short field. The Saints, you know, they haven't had a huge number of yards here tonight, but yardage, you know, total yards gained on the night isn't what wins you football games. Short field is a short field, touchdown is a touchdown, and they're up 20-0. Wow, this one is really a little bit surprising to me, Coach. I thought we'd have a tighter fought game here tonight. I am surprised a little bit.
Yes, I knew it would be a good football game, but like I said, right now Santa has the momentum. Everything they're doing is working for them, but yep. Like I said, hopefully they can keep going, and hopefully Seagrass can come back, so it's not over.
No, it's not over, not at all, and this is a tough game and a tough, tight order and a tough ride. This is not a rivalry game, but it's two schools that kind of, you know, I won't say there's bad blood between them, but maybe not they're each other's favorite programs. You know, the thing about the Saints last year, I know they had a great season and they ran into the buzzsaw of the Jaguars last season. They came in undefeated against the Jaguars and they played them. And then, of course, the Saints had an early exit, unfortunately, in the first round of the playoffs. Maybe get a few schools that maybe you're not expected to win, because that's kind of how you maybe make a better team.
You definitely get those W's. You need those just to get the going, the momentum going, because a lot of it is psychological. So once you start building your program, of course, you start challenging yourself with bigger and stronger opponents to make yourself build character and make you a good football team down the line.
Bouncing kick, and again, they've had troubles all night, handing the football here on the returns. Tries to take off, but again, with the limited time there now, with the wasted time with the ball being bobbled, as that was J.C. Cutavez. We haven't called his name out too much here tonight. He's been a mainstay out of the backfield for sure this season, coming into this game, and he hasn't had too many touches here tonight. So down he goes. Santa Ana High School to round out their rest of the season. 33-21 over Marina on the road. 25-20 they won at Valley High School back in week five. Beat Calvary Chapel 27-24. Beat Orange 31-well, they lost 31-29, but won by forfeit. And beat Loara 2 weeks ago, 35-0. Sigerson beat Loara just last week at Sigerson, 35-14. And of course, they're here tonight against Sigerson. Sigerson keeps the ball on the ground. Not much yardage there. That's probably going to be the end of the first half. As this game is going to come, this half is going to come to for Sigerson, a merciful end. Taking it out in big chunks here in the first half as they are really dominating 21-0. And again, they've had short fields and the benefit of that. And that's meant a lot, not everything, but a lot in this game. That's part of the reason why they are in control. Coach, I'm looking at this game, and it's a game in which the Saints have had the benefit of short field, but also, you know, they're looking sharp offensively and defensively. They had a few penalties, a few mistakes, but nothing major. They're playing some smooth football out there. They're looking sharp. They're not maybe hitting on all cylinders, but very damn near close.
Yeah, Santa Ana came out ranked number one. They're showing the reason why they are ranked number one. They're very strong, explosive football team, both sides of football, so they came to play, so it's not about that.
You're looking sharp. My name is Peter Pixine-Hebdell. We are here at Santa Ana Bowl, folks. Don't go away. We'll be back for the second half of Week 9's game here on October the 28th between the Jaguars and the Saints. Stay tuned.
History-making Santa Ana marching band, along with our award-winning